Hi, welcome back. This is Rakesh Naik. Today we are going to discuss about matrix operations. In last two videos, we have seen about arrays, one-dimensional and two-dimensional. In both of it, we learned about the definition, the operations, the memory locations and all this. And today we are going to discuss about the basic matrix operation. So before we start, a small information I'd like to share. In this channel, we produce every video in two different languages, Hindi as well as in English. So if you want to view it in Hindi, kindly follow the link given in the description. And if you have not yet subscribed, kindly press the subscribe button and then press the bell icon so that you will get all the updates from this channel. So let us start matrix operation. Let us start with transpose of matrix. Let me explain you what is transpose of matrix first, then we will go to this example. So in transpose of matrix, we convert the row element to the column element. It means first row element I will write as first column element, then second row element I will write as second column element, and the third row elements I will write as third column element. This is known as transpose of matrix. Let us try to understand this with the help of this example. Let us see, the first element of first row, that is 10, is moved to first element of first column. Now the second element of first row will be moved to the second element of first column. And the third element of first row will be moved to the third element of first column. Now if you see the relation, you can find A00 element is moved to B00 element, then A01 element is moved to B10 element, and A02 element moved to B20 element. So if you want to see the relation between them, you can find the second parameter or the second subscript of B is equal to the first subscript of A. It means whatever you are writing here in this relation, Aij becomes same as Bji. As we know, the first subscript indicates the row and the second subscript indicates the column. So whenever we are writing here I, it means we are referring to the column. Now let us see for one more row, the second row in matrix A. That is, first element is 40 and it is moved to the first element in the column in B. The second element is 50, it is moved to second element in B in the second column. And the third element of the second row is 60 and it is moved to third element of second column. The same relation established here, A10 value, that is 40, is moved to B01 location. Then A11 location is moved to B11 location, A12 location is moved to B21 location. The same relation holds here. So in this way we are going to do the transpose of matrix. So let us see the algorithm. We will try to first understand the algorithm and then we will go back to the program. So here transpose of matrix, for the rows I am taking the lower bound, it's supposed to be 0, and for j taking one more variable to indicate the lower bound of the column. So when this statement is executed, I value becomes 0. When this statement is executed, it becomes 0. When aij becomes bji, it means a00 value is moved to b00 value. It means 10 will be moved to this particular location. Now j will be incremented by 1. When j is incremented by 1, it will, j value becomes 1 and it will be checked with the upper bound of j. Now again the loop will be continuing, and here we will get the value in A01 location will be moved to location B10. Now also j will be incremented, j value becomes 2 and it will be compared with the upper bound of j, and it is not satisfying, then again we are repeating the loop. Again the same condition Aij equal to Bji, it means here A02 value is moved to B20 value. It means 30 is moved to this particular location. Again J is incremented by 1, J is now the value is 3, again it will be compared with the upper bound, and because it is this condition J is greater than upper bound is satisfying, that's where it will come out of the loop and it will say J equal, it will say I equal to I plus 1. Now after incrementing I, again we check the upper bound with I, now I value becomes 1. So again the outer loop again will be continuing for the second row. So when again it will come back to the inner loop, again J will become 0 and it will start working with this particular statement. So in this way we are going to implement the matrix transpose. So let us see the program in C++. We are taking I and J as two variable, one is for row, one is for column. And we are giving a output statement that matrix transpose of matrix is, for we are taking two for loops, for I equal to 0 to the row size and for J equal to 0 to the column size. Then this particular statement Aij value is moved to Bji value. So with this looping structure the transpose will be done. I hope you understood it. If you have not understood it, rewind and see it once more. Otherwise you will not be able to understand the further videos. So let us see about matrix addition. So in matrix addition what we do, we take the matrix of same size and the corresponding element of two matrices will take, add and save in the third matrix. And the location also will be same as the location we took it from matrix A and matrix B. The first element in matrix A is 10, the first element in matrix B is 110. So we want to add them up and the addition value 120 will write it in the location 00. You see, the location is preserved. From A we took the value, that is 10 at 00 location. At 00 location of B we found 110 and the sum is written in 00 location only. Similarly, the second elements of the first row we took, 140 were written in the second element of the first row. Similarly, the third element in the first row is picked up, the sum 160 is written in the as the third element in the first row. Similarly, take first element in the second row, 40 and 140, take both of them, sum it up and 180 you write in as the first element of second row. So in this way we are going to sum the matrix. Now let us see the matrix addition algorithm. We took I, a variable that indicates the lower bound for the row, and J, we are taking the lower bound for column. So I becomes 0 and J becomes 0. The corresponding element of A and B. So the first element, 00 element of A is 10 and 00 element of B is 110. We'll write 120 in 000 location. Again, after this statement we are going to increment J. J will become 1. We will check with the upper bound of J. J is not satisfying the upper bound, that's why it will repeat the inner loop. Again it will come to the inner loop for this execution. So C01 value we are going to find. So C01 value will be 20 plus 120, that is 140, will be saved at C01 location. Now J will be incremented by 1. And it will be compared with the upper bound. J value becomes 2 now. Again, we are repeating the inner loop to find C02 value. So C02 value becomes 160 like this. And J will be incremented. And after J is incremented, we are going to compare with the upper bound. And it is satisfying the condition. And that's why we are coming out of the loop. And I is incremented by 1. After I is being incremented by 1, we are comparing this with the upper bound of the rho. Upper bound of rho is 2 and now I value is 1. So that's why this condition is not satisfying. So again we will move up to continue the outer loop. So when we come inside, again J value, that column value becomes 0. So let us see the program for it. So here we are taking two variables I and J, and apart from that one more variable we are taking to save the sum of matrix, that is saved in C. Now let us see the program for this. We are taking two variables I and J and a variable C which is a 3 cross 3 matrix, because A and B we took as 3 cross 3 matrix. Now we are giving an output statement to show the sum of matrix. We are taking two loops, I is equal to 0, I is less than row size, I plus plus, and J is equal to 0, J is less than equal to column size, and J plus plus. We are exactly translating this particular statement here, that is Aij plus Bij, we are trying to save the value in Cij. So when both the loops execution will be completed, I'll get the total sum saved in the form of a matrix in Cij. I hope you understood it. Now again we will take one more complicated algorithm, that is matrix multiplication. So here we are going to learn how we can do matrix multiplication. First we will try to understand it with the help of an example, and then we will go for algorithm. Now if I want to multiply two matrices, here I am taking two same size matrix for your better understanding. So what we do when we multiply, we multiply the row elements of first matrix to the column elements of the second matrix. It means value 1, 2 and 3 will be multiplied to column value 11, 14 and 17. So in the first go what we will do, we will take the first elements and we will do the multiplication. Next we will take the second pair of elements, again we will multiply, and we will take the third pair of elements, again we will multiply. And the total sum will write in the first location of matrix C. So you can see here that C00 value, how we filled, that A00 is multiplied with B00, then A01 is multiplied with B10, and A02 value is multiplied with B20 value. The second subscript of A is the same as the first subscript of B. And this is keep on changing. In first pair of multiplication, you are having the common value is 0. In the second pair of multiplication, the common value is 1. And the third pair of multiplication, the common value is 2. So here we can write that Cij is nothing but multiplication of Aik and Bkj element, where k is varying from 0 to 2. So first pair of elements will take, will multiply, then second pair of elements will take, will multiply, and then we'll take the third pair of data, multiply and sum them up, 96 we'll put in the, we'll put as the second element in the first row. Here again we'll see the relation. The relation is A00 is multiplied to B01, A01 is multiplied to B11, and A02 is multiplied to B21. So here the common factor again the same. You can see that the second subscript of A is same as the first subscript of B in every pair of multiplication. And this value is changing from in first multiplication it is 0, in second multiplication it is 1, and in the third multiplication it is 2. So I can write here Cij equal to Aik into Bkj, where k is varying from 0 to 2. Let us see one more multiplication here. Again, you will take the first pair of elements, multiply, second pair of data, and then multiply, and then the third pair of data, multiply, sum them up and write it as a third element of the first row. Let us check the relation here. Again, we are finding the same relation. Within a multiplication, second subscript of the first matrix and the first subscript of second matrix remains the same. Here it is 0, here it is 1, and here it is 2. So the relation holds again the same. Cij equal to Aik into Bkj, where k is varying from 0 to 2. We can observe here that if matrix A is of size m cross n and matrix B is of size n cross p, then matrix C will be of size m cross p. And one more thing is that the second subscript of matrix A is supposed to be same as the first subscript of matrix B. It means the number of column in matrix A is supposed to be number of rows in matrix B. So let us see the algorithm first with the help of this example. So here is the algorithm matrix multiplication, and we have given 6 parameters. A, B, C are 3 matrices, and M, N and P are the rows and columns. It means for matrix A, the row M number of rows and N number of columns are there. For matrix B, N number of rows and P number of columns are there. To initialize I equal to 0, it means row number becomes 0. We will go to the repeat statement. Now J becomes 0. We will take one more variable for summing, because every time everything we are multiplying, we are summing it up. So Jij becomes 0. We are taking one more variable, that is K, and we are doing this multiplication. That is Cij equal to Cij plus Aik into Bkj. So here what we got? First pair of elements are multiplied. Earlier Cij value was 0, and that's why C00 value becomes 0 plus 1 into 11. That is first element of first row and first element of first column is multiplied. Now K is incremented by 1, and now K value becomes 1. And we'll check with the condition that K is greater than P or not. If it is not greater than, it will repeat the innermost loop. So again we'll come to this particular statement. So here the second element of first row and second element of first column has been multiplied. Earlier the sum was 11, so C00 becomes 11 plus 2 into 14. So the result becomes 39. Again K is being incremented, K becomes 2, it is checked with P, it is satisfying. Again it will go for the innermost loop and calculate this particular statement. It means third element of first row and third element of first column is being multiplied. So earlier we had 39 and we are adding 3 into 17. So we will get 90, and K is being incremented by 1. K becomes 3, and this condition satisfies now. So that's why we will come out and write in the value 90 over there. J is incremented by 1. After J has been incremented by 1, it is matched with the column. If it is satisfying, if it is not satisfying, it will repeat the second innermost loop, and we will take J value to be 1. Cij again becomes 1. K value again we will take to be 0. Again we are going to calculate this statement. So in this way we are going to do the multiplication. If you understood this process, the matrix multiplication becomes easy. We have exactly translated the algorithm to the program. So here we are taking 3 variables, I, J and K. We are writing a output statement here, and then 2 loops. So for I equal to 0, I is less than row size I plus plus. J equal to 0, J is less than column size J plus plus. We are taking Cij value to be 0 and taking one more loop, that is K. K will be going from 0 to P. With this particular statement, we are going to compute the matrix multiplication. Hope you understood these 3 operations. Hope you understood all these 3 operations. Thank you for watching till the end. And in the next video, we are going to talk about sparse matrix. So we'll meet again in our next video. Till then, take care. Bye.